blessings to you, people of God. I just want to share a testimony that's still developing. When I was younger and I separated from my husband, I would cook for my children and I would make sure they were full before I even ate. And so whatever was left, that's what I would eat. And so a lot of times I didn't have any leftovers for that day. And I would go to work the next day and I would eat ramen noodles because they were cheap. I didn't have the money to go and buy something to eat every day. And so I would just keep some ramen noodles and I would eat the ramen noodles for lunch. And then I would go and cook for my children and it'd be the same thing, you know, just about every day. And so those were hard times. They didn't seem really hard at the time, but they were hard times. And the Lord has revealed to me so many times throughout the years how he's going to bless me and I will live in abundance and how he's going to pour out blessings on me. I know that wealth is coming into my life. And so one day when I was at a prayer group, this young lady, she said to me, I hear God saying, no more ramen noodles. And so today, it just seems my account is a little opposite of what the promise of God has said. But I trust him because I've been here before. And what I keep hearing in my ear is, you know, today on my way to work, I was thinking, you know, the bank account's kind of low, so I better not spend no money. I'll go to the dollar store and get me some ramen noodles. And the Holy Spirit said, no more ramen noodles. And that's what I keep hearing all day. No more ramen noodles. Not that I don't eat ramen noodles. I'm not too good for them. But I don't have to eat them. It's not a necessity. I eat them when I feel like eating them. I don't eat them because I have to eat them because I don't have money to buy anything else. The Holy Spirit said, no more ramen noodles. So whatever the Lord has told you, whatever promise he's made to you, trust him. Don't fall back into fear and doubt. Just continue to trust him. Even when your situation is totally opposite to what he promised you, believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. God, I talk about all the time that he is a promise keeper. He is going to keep his promise to you. So don't doubt. Continue to believe what God has promised to you and you shall see it manifest in your life. Blessings to you, people of God.